I'm going to take you to the two important news of the week. From the next week, you can send me the different important news and I may select from those news and we may opt analyzing them. But the two important news of this week that I would like to bring forward to you are, number one is this one. Let us just see this one. So can you see the picture, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's play this and hear.
Year-old Sirisha Bandla will be making history as she becomes the second Indian-American woman to travel into space after Kalpana Chawla. She will be joining Virgin Galactic's Richard Branson VSS Unity to fly into space on July 11th. Born in Andhra Pradesh's Guntur, the aeronautical engineer will be taking care of the researcher's experience on the Unity 22 mission and will be part of a six-member crew. Sirisha completed her Bachelor of Science in Aerospace, Aeronautical and Astronautical Engineering in 2011 from Purdue University. She went on to complete her MBA from George Washington University in 2015. Joining Virgin Galactic after her studies, she is currently the Vice President of Government Affairs at the company. Her paternal grandfather also spoke up about how Sirisha was always looking up at the sky and how proud of her he was.
I don't know, she was very much fascinated in towards the sky, looking at the sky, space. In the meantime, she had a lot of training.
Bandla also took to Twitter, sharing that she was incredibly honored to be part of the crew. TOI Online Report.
So all of you have seen this news. Now I would like to know from you people, what do you think about this news and what do you actually get from it? Shreya, would you start with her?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, this news is a very special news for all of us and this is really very special and I love to see this very much, the news about how we are now getting a second Indian astronaut who is going to go to the space and going to represent India.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, Ronak, are you waiting to see this launch on 11th of July?
Yes, ma'am. I am eagerly waiting to see the launch because it's a very proud moment for our country.
Okay, and she's from Andhra Pradesh. Do you remember from where Kalpana Chawla was from? You have read a chapter in class 6 about the first Indian-American woman, Kalpana Chawla, who went to space. But an unfortunate event made us lose her. So we are all anticipating that moment and maybe praying to God that we don't lose our second person over there, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Swarndeep, would you like to add some points?
Ma'am, Kalpana Chawla was from Karnal.
Yes, absolutely. Haryana, Karnal, right? And Sirisha Bandla is from Andhra Pradesh, Guntur. Okay, and you all have seen this beautiful interview taken with her grandfather and how she was fascinated with the sky every time. Okay, Swati, can you tell me, just now in the video we heard the educational qualification that she had to go through to become such a space person. So can you tell me what were the educational qualifications? So what you have to do to go to space? What are the different kind of educational degrees you need according to, like, if we consider the life of Sirisha?
Ma'am, what I heard was Sirisha madam is Bachelor of Science in astronomy. So
this, and also aeronautical engineering, right? Do you find similarities? Kalpana Chawla was also an aeronautical engineer, if you remember.
Yes, I found the similarity in the beginning also.
Absolutely, and absolutely.
And now she's kind of resembling Kalpana Chawla too.
Yes, yes, yes. Agniv, do you have anything to say regarding this?
Ma'am, this is a karada jawab to those people who thought that women are not worthy of astronomy.
Okay.
She has become idol of many people who wants to become an astronaut and go to space.
Yes, in class 6 when we read about Kalpana Chawla, we read about how she motivated the women and the entire nation of India to come up and take such professions like being a space person, like being a the first person to go to space from India. Okay, so she was really inspiring, and again we have this lady who is inspiring so many young scientists, and maybe some of this young woman who will be getting inspired will be going to ISRO and then to NASA someday. Okay, so it's a very inspiring story. Okay, the next news is
really defining the fact that keep on running until you catch up, because her grandfather said that she always looked in the sky. And now
Absolutely.
She's really going there. So she kept on running until she catched up.
Okay. Isn't it like that animation movie Brave Song, Chase the Wind and Touch the Sky? She's literally touching the sky, right? Okay. So we are moving on to the next news, which is a little bit depressing. This was a very positive one. The next news is a little bit depressing. Not depressing, actually alarming. Okay, so I'll take you to the next news. 1 second. Now you can see it?
No. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is the United Nations page. Okay, United Nations news page. Whenever you want to know some news in detail or about need to read about something in depth, you can definitely visit this page. You see, over here are the different topics. Women, law and crime prevention, culture and education, health, climate and environment, there is peace and security, all these topics, on all these topics throughout the world, all the United Nations allying countries, they have their news over here. This is the United Nations page, and it shows a very alarming news where it shows that Canada is breaking the heat wave, and it is like a pressure cooker now. Canada, which was extremely known for its cold weather, the glaciers and the Rocky Mountains, it has shown extreme high temperatures. You can see the news. An exceptional and dangerous heat wave is breaking in northwestern United States of America and western Canada. This is obviously a part of the world which is more accustomed to cold weather, right? We all know Canada always have cold weather, but this time what happens? See below. It is 47.9 degrees Celsius. 47.9 degrees Celsius is the recording temperature. Okay, and don't forget that this is the province which has the Rocky Mountains, the glacial natural park, and if it starts increasing more, then obviously these mountains will lose the ice in them, and it will be an extreme threat. There will be floods and landslides and everything. Okay, you can see in this video the portions which are experiencing the heat wave. See? An extreme heat wave going to Vancouver, Oregon, and Washington. These are the few places which are experiencing this extreme high temperature in Canada. Okay, so what can you tell me about this? Why do you think this temperature is rising? Can anybody tell me? Shriduti, can you tell me what is your view on this extreme temperature rise?
Ma'am, because of the global warming.
Absolutely, because of the global warming. Okay, Dipanjan, can you tell us, enlighten us a little bit about global warming? Dipanjan?
Ma'am, global warming is a natural phenomenon in which the overall temperature of the atmosphere increases rapidly, and due to this increment, many side effects happen to our environment and also biological diversity. Like due to increasing temperature, the ice caps can melt down, and this can cause a shortage of habitat for that and for those animals in the poles, and also it can increase the water level. Increasing the sea level in the waters can cause many disturbances in the coastline areas of the world. So it is a very dangerous phenomenon and the most endangering threat of us in recent days.
Very well said, very well said. Agniv, can you tell me, Dipanjan has said it is due to the rise of temperature. What is the main reason behind this rise of temperature? Global warming is what we are calling this rise of temperature, but what is the main reason? Agniv, can you tell us? Yes, anybody wants to say?
Yes, ma'am, can I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, because of the cutting of trees.
Cutting of trees is one reason, but there are some more reasons. Can anybody
due
explain?
Due to the factories. It is
factories. So what is happening due to the factories? I want a specific word. You all are missing that word. Due to the cutting of trees, due to the increase of
CO2 level, it is reducing the ozone layer and the air traps inside and it cannot get outside.
Absolutely. The depletion of the ozone layer is one of the most important causes of the global warming. Depletion of the ozone layer. So can you tell me one of the ozone layer is getting depleted due to the greenhouse gases, right? So can you name one of the greenhouse gases? CO2 is one of them, definitely. And other?
Methane.
Then there is one specific gas which is used in two of our technical gadgets, which we use a lot nowadays.
CFCs
are used in which two technical things that we have in our homes?
ACs
and refrigerators. And nowadays there are so many official complexes which are centrally AC, right? So think about the amount of CFC that is getting getting its exposure in the air, all the kind of different kind of due to the less number of trees, due to the increase of factories, due to the increase of the CFC gas in the air. All these are reason behind the ozone layer depletion. And when the ozone layer is getting depleted, the ultraviolet rays are reaching the earth surface more and more, causing the global warming in an increased fashion, right?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, here comes a funny fact that due to the increasing use of ACs, we increasingly need the use of ACs.
Absolutely. This is the funny fact. See, the one who is making it is the one who is trying to protect us from the heat. Or maybe one who is trying to protect us from the heat is the one which is making it.
Yes,
right?
Ma'am.
Absolutely. So these were the two important news I wanted to share with you people. And I got very interesting updates from you people, and your analysis were also very interesting. So I think for the next week, you can bring up your own news materials. Now you would be able to make out your own news materials for the next week, Thursday.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.